Hello, everyone, and happy Wednesday if you are watching this on Wednesday. So I thought I might break up your YouTube and maybe even Instagram feed with something a little bit different. I know that it is planner launch season, and today, oh my goodness, there are a lot of videos out there for a particular launch, and I don't know about you, but I need a breather. So today I wanted to share with you guys the order that I placed during the Simplified Planner launch. All right, so let's get right into it. Now I do want to preface this by saying I will not be doing a pen test on these planners simply because I am giving them as a gift. So if you need a pen test, you can watch some of my previous Simplified Planner reviews. The paper is the same and amazing and fantastic, so trust me, you don't need a pen test. This is great paper. Okay, so I ordered two of the Simplified Daily Planners. I have been a longtime fan of Emily Lay and her brand and her team. They just do amazing things over there. And I just think that they're great. So I purchased the brand new thin Happy Stripe. The Happy Stripe pattern has been a staple over at Simplified since the very beginning, and they've always kind of changed it up a little bit, and this year is no different. It is absolutely beautiful. I also got the Kelly Green Bees color. The second I saw this when they did their cover reveal over on Instagram, I was like, I need to see this in person. This green is absolutely stunning. Oh my goodness. So let's talk about the specifications on the outside. It has a gold wire O binding. You guys know it's not my favorite binding for a planner. However, this binding does hold up for the whole year. I have used a Simplified Planner in the past, and it is a very well done wire O binding in that beautiful gold color. They do not have any other wire O binding color options, so you'll want to keep that in mind when you go ahead and purchase if gold is not your favorite. They do have their standard hard cover with the gold rivets on the corner. Is that what you call those things? Rivets? Dammits? I don't know. Corner protectors, although I feel like I need protection from these sometimes for myself because they can be a little sharp. So these will keep your cover nice and brand new looking all year long. On the back of the planner, you'll see on both of these, it does have the Simplified branding. I love that it's on the back and not in your face. Just very well done. When you do get your planner, and I've already taken these out of the boxes to save just my sanity because it's very well packaged. It's got bubble wrap and shrink wrap, and it's just very well packaged. But you do get this navy blue and gold keepsake box, super durable. So if you're someone who likes to keep your planners, you can put it back in here at the end of the year and just pop it on the shelf. I think it even has, yes, it has the year and everything right there on the binding of the box here for you, so you know exactly what planner you're pulling off the shelf. All right, so the Simplified Daily Planner is, the cover itself is 7x9. The pages themselves are 6x8¾. Like I said, their paper is absolutely amazing, and I'm just gonna get one of these out of the way because they are exactly the same on the inside. So Emily Lay uses 70-pound Mohawk paper. It is one of the best out there. Mohawk in general creates amazing paper for a lot of different planner companies like Simplified. You do have a pocket in the front cover, and it does come with, now this was an error I noticed on mine. I think it's only supposed to come with one sheet of stickers, and mine came with two, and the other one doesn't want to come out. There we go, I got it out. But it does come with a sheet of stickers that has a bunch of functional and a few decorative stickers on there. I do love these little flags. They are so, so cute. Those fit in there perfectly for you. This planner does retail for $60. Now, that's a little bit on the higher end for a coil planner. Actually, I wouldn't even say it's on the higher end. It's pretty standard if you look at different prices of planners out there. A full year daily planner at $60 is pretty standard. So it's really not too bad, especially if you are going to actually use it for the whole year. The other thing that I love are the tabs on the Emily Lay Simplified Planner. Look at those colors. They are absolutely gorgeous. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. And they are very, very durable. They will last you all year long. So let's jump right into the planner itself. I don't want to take up too much of your time. You have a title page where you can put your name. You have a little area where they tell you what they're all about. A letter from Emily. the process of simplifying and how to use your planner. Another thing I wanted to add is that they now include this little fresh start guide that comes in your box with your planner. So that is something new that they are doing this year, which I think is really cool. There's a video library, a Facebook, a free printable library when you make a purchase with them. It talks about her books. She actually has another book that just came out, which I have yet to get, but it's on my list. If you have a Simplified Planner account, they do have like a referral link type thing. So if you use, say, my referral, you get $10, I get $10, pretty cool, all that stuff. So I love this little guide that came with it. So there's also a guide in here on how to use your planner. You do get a full 2021, well, academic year 2021 to 2022 planner, along with a list of holidays. You get an area for preparing for your new year where you can do some reflection, go over some routines, both your morning and your evening. And let me kind of zoom you guys in just a little bit more so you can get a closer look. Then you have the Simplicity Challenge, which is actually going on right now. If you go over to Emily Lay's Instagram page, you can kind of follow this Simplicity Challenge along with them. But again, this book does not start till August. You have your yearly bucket list. That's super fun. And then you get four notes pages. That's probably going to be my biggest gripe, is the four notes pages and this YRO binding. Not my favorite binding, like I said before, and four notes pages is definitely not enough, but I think you have to remember, though, the amount of pages that are in here because it is a full year planner. All right, so you jump right into August. You do have a full month on two-page view, lots of space, very simple, straight to the point. You do get the month previous and the month forward up here on the corner for you so that you can kind of use that when you're doing your planning. Now, here are how the pages look in the Simplified Planner. You do get a day per page from Monday through Friday, but Saturday and Sunday are shared. That works for some people, not so much for others. So in a regular day to day, this is what it's gonna look like for you. Your day is timed for you from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. Then you've got the same amount of space for your to-do list and an open area that you can do whatever you want with. It's labeled notes. Before, I think it used to say like meal plan or something like that over the years, and I think it was also split. They kind of left it open for you to use however you want, which I absolutely love. So there is that in the Simplified Planner. I just think that this is a really great planner. I have used it before for work, personal stuff, business stuff. The paper is great. The company is great. This is a really great planner overall. And then each month, just kind of, there's not really a color scheme for the month. It's just on the tab. So each day will change color for you, which is kind of what I like. It's not neutral, but it is in its own weird way. Like Simplified Planner's neutral is the happy stripe color. So it doesn't feel like there's a lot of color on these pages, if that makes sense. So let's just go ahead and skip all the way to the end. There are not any notes pages in the back of the book, which is where I would have preferred that they put the notes pages instead of in the front. But honestly, I just wish that there was maybe a notes page kind of like at, say, like right here when this month ends and you're about to go to the next tab. It would be nice to have one or two notes pages there and then go into the month. But again, the coil would probably be a lot bigger. And there you go. There's no pocket back here. And for the Kelly Green book, the inside lining is this kind of like baby blue color, which is really pretty. And see, this is the issue with the YRO. Getting it back closed. For the happy stripe, the inside color is going to be that navy blue. All right, the next item that I grabbed is their new monthly book. I was like, I have to check this out. It's $18 and it does come with, let's see if I can get this cover off. I got the blush stripe color. I thought that this was so pretty. Now this is something I'm probably going to keep for myself. I thought about using it as a content planner. I think that this is so pretty and just very like light and easy to just kind of stuff in like a backpack or a purse or something like that where you just aren't really worried about bulk. So the size of this is 8x10. Like I said, it's $18. And what I love is that they actually used the same paper that is in the daily planner in this monthly planner. Sometimes I feel like planner brands will skimp on the paper for lower priced products and not necessarily give you the same quality paper. And Emily Lay has not done this here. They're giving you the same 70-pound Mohawk paper in this monthly planner. So The inside of this book has this nice blush pink color. You have your title page, same like the daily, where you can put your name. You get the full year at a glance, academic, of course. You get your 2021 and 2022 holidays. You have got this like giant month on two pages, so much bigger than what you're getting in the daily. And of course, it starts in August of 21, and it just goes month to month. And it appears like the colors are the same kind of color variation as you would find in the daily. You do get your monthly simplicity tip along with the month prior and the month going forward. So let's flip forward to the end of this planner. And one of the things that I love is that it comes with 13 notes pages, which I think is great. It might not be quite enough. I guess you won't know until you actually start using it. You could easily use this as your meal planner if you just want to use something monthly. Like I said, you could use it for content. You could use it as a family planner so that your family is not in your main like decorative planner, but you just need something for like all the kids' activities and doctor's appointments, and you want to keep kind of your decorative space to yourself. This would be great for that. So like I said, you get 13 notes pages. They are all lined. There's no pockets or anything with this planner, so it's very simple and straight to the point. It does come in a couple of other patterns, but I chose to get the blush stripe. This is super, super pretty. And if you just want to try out the Emily Lay paper and not necessarily spend a ton, this is going to be a great way to check it out because, like I said, it's only 18 bucks. All right, next up, I got the Kelly Green Bees Mini Notebook. I've been a huge fan of these notebooks. I'm actually like a huge sucker for the mini notebooks. I buy a ton of them and then never use them. I know that a lot of you feel me on that. So, of course, it comes in the Kelly Green Bees pattern with the gold foil. Very, very pretty. It has 48 lined pages, 24 front and back, and it feels thicker than the paper in the planner, but it's not thinner, that's for sure. So I love that even in this little $10 notebook, they're giving you very high quality paper. There's no color on any of the pages. The little pineapples are actually a kind of like a slate gray. There aren't any pockets or anything in this book, but this is like good quality. If you're gonna toss this in and out of your purse or backpack or whatever it is that you carry all year long, this is gonna last. Like the cover is super thick, the paper is super thick, and I think it would just like add to like a nice gift or something. The other thing that I like is that if you want to use this as a companion to your daily simplified planner, it will actually fit in this pocket in the front up here. So you can just tuck it in there nicely and close your book and be done, and you'll have those note pages since the daily only comes with four. All right, the next item that I grabbed is the Happy Stripe Planner Pouch. This is also a new release item for them with this planner launch. Let me take this blue cover off. I absolutely love this. It is huge. It is huge, you guys. Now, this planner pouch does retail for $28, so it kind of comes with a hefty price tag in my opinion. It is 9 by 12. It fits all the things. It does come with a gold zipper with a pineapple zipper pull, and on the inside, the lining is navy, which is, you know, kind of true to their colors, Happy Stripe having the navy on the inside. This does come in a couple of other color variations. I just chose to get the Happy Stripe one. So it actually does fit your daily just fine in here. So if you want to put your, oh, did I have this open all the way? Okay. So if you want to put your planner in here, it's going to fit just fine. My only worry though is that as you're pulling your planner in and out of this pouch, that the teeth might cause some damage to your cover, especially if you're using it all year long. But just kind of, you know, handle with care. That's just what I would do. But you could fit easily a few pens, a notebook, your planner in here. There's a lot of space. I also just love pouches, and I would probably use this for travel or just something like that. It has this beautiful like nylon material that is gonna be easy to wipe clean. It does have the simplified branding on the backside. Or the front, whichever, you know. But I love this. I can't wait to use this for probably mostly for travel, like toiletries and things like that I can toss in here. But this is a really, really cute bag, and it would also make a great gift. All right, last but certainly not least is a little gift to myself, and I grabbed the Grace Not Perfection necklace. I was so excited when I saw this was coming. One, because I love pineapples, and two, I just This looked absolutely beautiful when they mentioned it over on their Instagram. So it has this sort of like medallion type gold pendant on it. I don't know, I'm not a jeweler, but it does say grace, not perfection on one side, and then it has the pineapple on the other. I love that it is 18 and a half inches in length, and it does come with a 2-inch extender. I'm gonna try and get it off of this packaging without breaking it. I am pretty rough on jewelry, so I'm gonna be really curious to see how this is going to last. This is like really well put in here. All right, there we go. So this is how it looks, and you can see it has the extender on here in case you wanted to hang a little bit lower, which is kind of the preference for me. I do not like when necklaces are super tight around my neck, but this is really beautiful. It is 24 karat gold plated, so we will see how long it lasts. Now this does retail for $40, a little bit pricey, but again, I got it as a gift for myself, and I'm really excited about it. This would also make a really great Mother's Day gift. I don't know what their shipping time would be to get it in time. I know Mother's Day is like next week, but I ordered my stuff on launch day. It shipped like the next day and I got it just a couple days later. So you probably could order today and get it as a gift. All right, so that is everything for my order from the Simplified Planner launch. I am really excited to see a lot of these new colors and patterns that they are offering this year. As I said before, Emily Lay is a planner brand that I have absolutely loved supporting throughout the years. So if you are interested in trying out this brand, I definitely highly, highly recommend checking them out. If you have any questions about any of the items that I mentioned in today's video, please feel free to comment down below and I'll answer them as best as I can. I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. And if you are already subscribed, make sure that your notifications are on so that you know when my videos are posted here on YouTube. As always, thank you guys so much for joining me and I will see you in my next video. Bye everyone.